Munchkins and viewers alike, it's me, Munchie, and welcome back to a good, a bad, a Craigslist pet ad. I'm doing my thing because I can, because it's Munchie time, hey, it's Munchie time. Gonna review those ads, gonna go check out ads, that's all I can think about is our ads. Welcome on in, everybody. This is apparently the favorite and most requested poll video. Let's take our cat cup and sip. Stress relief tea. Kava. So, today, we're not spilling tea. Well, not necessarily. But we're gonna be checking out in your area or your requested area. Thanks to you guys on this screen right over here where I did a little shout out on YouTube saying, hey, let me look in your area for the next Craigslist ads. Well, I didn't say that specifically, but basically I mentioned, if you want me to check out your area, I will go ahead and do so. So that's what we're doing today. And I am actually not gonna be doing it on that screen. I am not really set up to have a camera facing this way, unfortunately. So we got good angle, good lighting over here. I'll just do everything on the laptop, which I will just put my teacup aside and have this nice three screen setup right here. While that's chilling on in the background, my computer fans are revving up because I'm currently rendering a video for you guys. Now, the reason why we review these ads is not just for entertainment value, but for educational purposes and the encouragement that you guys would think adoption first and check out rehoming ads online. We're gonna be mainly talking about hamsters, gerbils, and mice in this video because that's the animals I wish to be looking up in your area today. But I also want to just notify people. Not all the times people are rehoming these animals because they have temperament issues or there's something wrong with them. Usually it's the opposite way around. Kidding. I'm kidding. Sometimes people are really, really bad and shady on Craigslist ads, which you guys really come here for that type of tea, you know? We'll sip to that. But in some of these cases, some people just did not start off with proper information and are rehoming due to a move, no longer can afford to take care of the animal, etc. So while this is kind of a reaction video, I also hope to encourage people to be educated in this video by telling you what type of care is wrong or right. We're hopefully gonna find maybe some positive care for rehomes, but a lot of the times the rehomes are due to just maybe hamster escaping, maybe new child. There's a lot of different things. So educate for what we see that's wrong, maybe what we see that's right, that I hope you guys can identify yourselves out there, and also just to encourage you guys to look on Craigslist and places and not support breeding mills that supply pet stores and cut corners during the pandemic by pushing out young animals in pet stores before they're even ready to be shipped. So that's what's been happening and it's been driving me absolutely crazy. So please guys, think about adoption first. By the way, if you're wondering why I'm so pink, pink is not my favorite color. I do have a pink setup, but you're probably wondering about that. So the pink chair, the pink lamp, and the pink pad that you see before you, my ex-roommates gave all this stuff to me for free, except for the chair. I had to pay her for the chair because my old chair was really bad and needed to go. I did not want to theme it pink. I am not a pink person, although I'm wearing a pink shirt, but that's because it's the Game Grumps. All right. That's one of the only reasons why I have a pink shirt. I basically look like Ariel in that pink dress, and I absolutely adore that pink dress, by the way. If you guys are throwing shade about the Ariel red hair pink dress situation, it looks like we got Texas coming up here. Edinburgh, I think that's how you pronounce it. I'm sorry, people out there, if I pronounce your place of origin incorrectly. But Sierra Moore Edinburgh, she suggested. There we go, we got Edinburgh, Texas here. And so I am typing hamster first. There's two places on Craigslist you need to be checking out for animals, by the way, if you're interested. It's sales and community. Community has the pet tab. Sales has people that really don't care and throw hamsters over there in general for sale. Oh goodness. Oh, we got some lovelies right here. Wow, what a vague ad. Dwarf hamster, $15. Dwarf hamster. Well, that was short, sweet, and simple. Can't really review that. Let's go. Oh, by the way, we usually have the rating system just to keep this kind of fun and entertaining. So number 5, positively perfect. Number 4, doing a good job so far. Number 3, needs improvement. Number 2 is, yikes, not good. And number 1 is, neglectful and sad and downright, I don't want to be on this planet anymore. That's what number one is. It is downright neglectful and sad. We are just looking at these ads basically to give you an idea what's in your area. So some of these, it looks like we might not even be really reviewing today. I could just tell you my commentary pretty much for these, but this one's another dwarf hamster, which it looks like the first one could either be classified as a Campbell's Russian dwarf hamster that's a hybrid because of the gray coloration, or it could be a winter white, but with that head, it's like it is a Campbell's, but it could also be a winter white. It's very hard. And then the second one, clearly it does look like a Campbell's Russian dwarf. It says dwarf hamster spotted and gray. I thought it was gonna say spotted and angry. Asking 15. It must be the same person. That looks like the same person, which clearly it looks like they must be either accidental litter or breeding. And I absolutely hate when people breed. But I also understand that there's some people that stick two hamsters together and not understand that that's wrong, and then find out the pet store gave them two opposite gender hamsters, or they went back, got one, stuck it together, and realized, oh gee, that's a boy. Let's look at the teddy bear. Oh god, it's in a very bad setup. Oh, teddy bear hamster. Selling two teddy bear hamsters. Well, there's one pictured, but this looks like a very young Syrian hamster. If I can guess, it's possibly just a couple months old. Doesn't look to be in good condition. However, they could have just woken it up. It has nothing but hay bedding. And that's not good. Hay does not absorb ammonia. And they're going to be sitting in their own filth for a while. And you can't really see much. But it says selling two teddy bear hamsters, male and female, $20 each, which they could be in their separate containers. Who knows? 10 for the cage. Oh, God. Oh, this is downright neglectful and sad right here. Just knowing what this looks like. And I really do hate it when people take Craigslist ad pictures of their pets in really weird backgrounds or setups. It kind of gives you an idea of the living situation, which can a lot of the times be not so great. And, oh gosh, these guys, if someone needs saving in this area, this is who you want to save. This was posted 24 days ago, however, so they may or may not be still there. Male and female, $20 each. That's a pet store price tag right there at the rescue here. We only adopt out Syrian hamsters at adoption fee of $10 because we understand that we're not making any money from them, and usually that's just a small price to put in our gas tank for to and from transportation. So, with that mouthful being said, this is just so sad, and even though we can't really see the setup, it screams not okay. Alright, so there's not really a whole lot here, but the thing is, if you type in hamsters, there might be something that pops up even more in this area, which it doesn't look like there is. So we're gonna actually switch and go to community, and hamster reduced must go. Oh my. Oh! I can't tell if this is truly their photos or if this is photos they pull from online, but it actually kind of reminds me of what I see on Asian markets in Singapore. I actually see a lot of Facebook posts about this too, where they will show tons and tons of baby hamsters, and for whatever reason this is just giving me those vibes, and I just don't know why. But yeah, these are all very small photos, which makes me think that they're not actually theirs, but yeah, no, I just don't know. This gives me really bad breeder vibes. Hamsters ready to go to their new homes, asking a low rehoming fee of 8. For more information, call or text. This could actually be a breeder. So for those people who are wondering about breeders, backyard breeders in your area, if you want to, please flag them. If you know for a fact they are breeding constantly, if you see their ads in this one particular area, say for instance, if you're just constantly screenshotting and you know that they're in this one little section here and they keep appearing in this one little section, and you can kind of see the streets and everything like that, and you're like, huh, that's the same one as last time, let me pull up a screenshot. Oh my gosh, it is. It could be the person still trying to sell hamsters from past litters, or they're constantly keep breeding them. I know of several breeders here in Washington State where they clearly say what year and day that they were born on, so it makes tracking their new litters so much easier. If you suspect that they are breeders and they are just trying to seek profit, this, they can cut corners here. They can definitely cut corners when you give them money, and if they sell them when they're still very young so they don't have to put a lot of time and effort into them, then that's how they can try to make money. Especially during the pandemic, there's a lot of people, and it's been reported too, that criminals for whatever reason get into the breeding hobby. If you do suspect that they are breeders, just flag them, because breeders are not allowed on Craigslist and we got to keep Craigslist clean. So if you do suspect that they are breeding, flag them. The next one, Tacoma, Washington. Now, that's not really that fun. I'm so sorry, Savannah. I'm sorry. We're going to be doing out of the state because you guys tend to see a lot of my area's Craigslist ads, but I want to see your area's Craigslist ads. Columbus, Ohio. Thanks, Jazzy, for submitting that. Black Bear Hamster, which is not a thing. That's just a nickname. Hamster female with home, wheel, water bottle, bedding, food. Okay, so this looks like a promising one we could check out. Black Bear Hamster, which actually doesn't show much at all. But let's just read it. Black Bear Hamster, he is a boy. He's a very, very loving hamster. He prefers attention and to be out rather than in the cage. His name is Coco. Coco comes with his cage and all his accessories. $45 for Coco with all. I will not separate anything. I will not give him away for free. I will not send codes. Oh no! They've been contacted. By the way, this is a good reach out announcement. If you're inquiring for an animal on Craigslist and somebody says, hey, in order to verify that you're a legit sender, I'm gonna send you this link. Click on it and tell me what code it says. Don't do that. That's a scam. Don't send them codes because what happens is they can get access to your phone number and they can actually create accounts under your phone number, which is actually a really big hassle. So don't do it. It is very bad. You will probably have to call your phone provider to let them know you have been scammed. But this is a scam when people say, hey, I have this Craigslist ad. I'm going to draw in the attention because people want hamsters, which actually has happened recently to a person I know. So they were contacting a person saying that they have hamsters, but that person says, oh, I need to make sure you're legit first. Here's the link. Give me the code. Oh, code's not working. Could you provide another phone number? Don't do it. Hamster female with home. She's a winter white and sapphire dwarf hamster mix. Are you saying that you bred a hamster that's a winter white and a Campbell's Russian dwarf hamster? Or are you just saying that that's the coloration you're assuming? Weird. Anyways, only 3 months old, the perfect gift for Christmas. Are you kidding me? Oh my God. Oh, I hate this person already. Hamster home included with everything she needs. $60 value at any pet store for only $40 cash only. No snakes or reptile owners. Only going to a good home. Not to be used as food. This person has clearly tried marketing before for maybe items or just trying to get people to buy. Because it sounds very market professional. But at the same time, this is an animal. This is a freaking animal. Can you tell me more about the animal? Nope. It just comes with these accessories. This is all I see the animal for. And these are all the photos you're ever gonna get, which this does look like a winter white hamster for sure. Serious inquiries only, please. I hate when people say that. It doesn't make a lick difference if you get someone that isn't serious or one that is serious. It really doesn't change people from contacting you. Oh, and then it says first come, first serve. So this person, oh, you present money to me. Okay, I shall take. You're the first one. If you come right here, right now, it's all for you. I don't like this. I don't like this at all. We cannot see the enclosure, but it looks like it's a bin cage at least. It looks like it is at least an 8-inch wheel from PetSmart. So I can't really make a assessment for this one. So let's just move on. Oh, I could definitely make an assessment of this. Hamster with cage. Fun, loving hamster with cage. Ball, food, and bedding. Great fun for kids. No. Oh, really? Is this a toy you're marketing to me, kind sir or madam? Because a hamster is a living thing, you piece of... Aw, what a beautiful hamster. The coloration looks like it is a Campbell's Russian dwarf hamster. However, the body type is quite round. So it's throwing me off here. This actually might just be a winter white just because of that body. That body definitely does not, especially with the sides hanging out there too like that. It looks like a winter white. Now winter whites have a few different colorations that are very similar to Campbell's Russian dwarf hamsters. And because Campbell's Russian dwarf hamsters are hybrids, it sometimes gets very confusing with the coat types and colorations and winter whites, specifically the golden colorations or the yellow line colorations, they tend to have red eyes, and it is very common in Petco to be producing what they call sunfire coloration. But this one right here, I don't know the name of the coloration, but unless I have the hamster physically, I cannot tell you if that's a Campbell's Russian or a winter white. It does look like it's storing its food up top here. It is the appropriate size for those tubes for the hamster, so we don't have complaints about like, oh, it's gonna get stuck in the tubes. Although winter whites are the bigger of the dwarf hamsters and they are very round, so it might actually be more difficult to get their body mass up and down because it just goes straight up and straight down. And even though there is rims inside the tubes there, it can be a tight squeeze just for them. But at least they have a hide in here. It looks like they do have more chew toys. The wheel is still inside of it. However, that wheel is really small. It's a 5-inch wheel for a winter white or Campbell's Russian dwarf hamster, which they should have at least a minimum of an 8-inch wheel. And it looks like they have an exercise ball and blueberry yogi treats over on the side here. They do look like they have, I want to say, an inch of bedding. It can be pushed and piled high inside that hide, which hamsters will do if given a hide and if they want to secure themselves in that hide. So it's low bedding. It's not that great. It is functioning though, but it kind of also looks like it's relatively new. Could have been a hamster that they've kept for maybe a month or two. They do have the right type of attitude when it comes to housing the animal, but of course the cage is too small. It's below 450 square inches as a recommendation in the US, and it's a critter trail, which should be about 120 square inches, and it's a breakable enclosure, and for whatever reason they have the door upside down. They did not assemble this right. Which, hey, I've made that mistake too in the past for tiny tailed cages, but those cages are actually kind of harder to assemble than critter trails. Plastic is being wasted and thrown in our landfills. It breaks easy. Katie is just a throwaway company at this point when it comes to their enclosures, but it kind of makes you wonder if they do this on purpose. But anyways, needs improvement is what I give it. It's being provided with bedding. It is being provided with chew toys. They do have a wheel in there. It's not the worst thing I've ever seen, but it really needs improvement, so they need to be re-educated. But at this point in time, unfortunately, they cannot be, because they're just trying to get rid of the animal at this point, so there's no point in contacting this person and saying, hey, I need to educate you, this is not a good setup, because they're just not going to care. So at this point, what you want to do if you want to educate people is actually reach out to them in hamster groups. Like, if people are inquiring or posting pictures of their hamsters, inquire there. That is a good conversation starter, not rehoming ads. Oh, this is a monstrosity. I've reviewed this type of enclosure. Oh god, and they want $60 for it. Ugh, ugh. This cage, I think I got for about 40 or 45 new. And I can see where this is kind of a higher rehoming fee for the type of things that it comes with. Just because they want to at least still be making that money back. But they, it's so bare, it's so awful. $60, him plus cage, pickup only, please. He's really sweet and cute. I just haven't felt a bond with him like my rats. That's so sad. I don't think he's the right one, even though maybe I did absolutely no research. I bought him on impulse. I thought he was cute, but I'm just not really attached to him. Sad, 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 sad. So, let's take a look at it. The water bottle is all the way up top. The middle portion of this cage has a tube that looks like it's in the air. And yes, there are tubes going up to the other compartment. Down below, that's hay! Hay is a nesting material, it is not bedding, it doesn't absorb ammonia. What is wrong with people? Oh my gosh, and they have rats too, so I'm surprised that there is not any sort of like paper bedding in here. I mean, rats do use fleas, but I'm just so surprised by how horrible this looks. There's no chew toys. The food is probably scattered at the bottom here, or could be in the middle, as you can see there. This is a very lackluster setup. The wheel, you can still see the wheel inside of there. That looks like a winter white hamster. You can definitely tell by that body type and coat coloration that that definitely looks like a winter white hamster. And that wheel, when we measured it in the enclosure that I reviewed, it was, I want to say, a 4-inch wheel, 4.5-inch wheel. So that thing's tiny in comparison to other wheels. This is one of those enclosures that's very easy to make and to import from China. I don't specifically know if this brand was the one that came out of China. This could be downright neglectful and sad. Should this be a yikes not good? It is being provided with layers, which is not what they need. They need horizontal space, not up in the sky. However, this has its own layers where there's no fall damage that could be present. Now, this cage is not as dangerous as one that just has one ledge, then another ledge, then another ledge, and then all open space here where the hamster could plummet all the way down to the bottom. This is at least safe for the most part, but again, you got the plastic material, you got the hay bedding. I don't see any hides. Like, if we're looking over here, where's the hides? There's no hides in here. Actually, no, this is downright neglectful and sad because there's no hides, incorrect bedding, the food's all scattered up here. Because there's no bedding in the upper layers, you have ammonia sticking to plastic, so you can smell that sucker, besides the hay being terrible. That could also just be straw. It doesn't really necessarily look like hay, which actually makes me even more nervous. What, is this person keeping horses too? And is treating the horses better than they are the small animals? I have no idea. But yeah, no, this is downright neglectful and sad. This poor, what I can only assume is a winter white, however it's very conflicting, but I do believe that's a winter white, just from what I can see from the body structure in this one, that it's a winter white, and just the size comparison to that 4-inch wheel. A Robo would look a little bit more fit on a 4-inch wheel because of how small they are. So, downright neglectful and sad. Moving on. Oh, here's something that's bright. Even though this isn't really a good ad, it says right here that this cage that they're reselling, which is a KT Critter Trail, they're saying this is a $5 hamster cage, great for traveling. So they are aware it is for traveling. Kudos. I like that. Now, these ads really do freak me out a little bit here. Looking for a small animal to add to family. Looking for a hamster, guinea pig, or bunny. I have all the caging and bedding and food supplies. I am just looking for the pet itself. I am not a huge fan of pet stores, so I would rather adopt. Just let me know what you have, please. Now, with this one, they are looking for a hamster, guinea pig, or bunny. But say they have all the supplies already present. That is just red flags right there. This could be a snake owner. You want to know why? Because hamsters, they like bigger hamsters, or they just like hamsters in general. Now, hamsters back in the days were used a lot for snake food, and they still are in specific areas or specific mom and pop pet stores that breed their supply in store. Terrible, I know. And a lot of people say they like using dwarf hamsters because it's very easy to breed them. And if they have bigger snakes, they use Syrians. I know this is probably damaging to your ears, but this is reality. So here we go, guys. Guinea pigs, again. You know, they are just saying hamster or guinea pig, not pigs, not two. And guinea pigs are fed to very large snakes or bunny. I mean, these have different dietary needs. They have different enclosures. They have different lifestyles. They have different expectancies. It's just, there's so many different things. And saying you have all the caging and bedding and food supplies, and you're just looking for the pet itself, red flag, this most likely is a snake. Looking for a free meal, pretty much, or just looking for some victim that will give them an animal. And the reason why they're not a huge fan of pet stores is possibly due to the fact that maybe they've been banned from pet stores, and or they can't access a pet store right now, maybe because they don't have a car, or they rather not go to pet stores because I hear all the time people complaining about feeder mice being way too expensive because they raised the price at Petco from like $4 to $5.49. Whoa, they're getting so expensive, guys. Oh my gosh, it's my allowance for a week as a child, pretty much. But in regards to pet stores, I'm sure if you have a big animal, big snake, that pet stores won't just give you or sell to you an animal unless you have a cage set up. At least in 2020 and 2021, I heard a lot of people say the pet store at least sold me and told me I needed to get an enclosure before they would give me the animal if I did not have one, or they would question me if I had an enclosure. So at least they're trying. However, I'm sure not all pet stores are going to question you about setup and will just sell you the animal. But at least from what I hear, there is an increase of people saying, I'm not gonna sell you anything until you tell me what you got. That was definitely me when I was working at a pet store. So this right here just screams possible snake owner. Ben Salem, Pennsylvania. There we go. And thank you to the Palest with the Laughing Patrick icon. Hi, the Palest. People say that I'm pretty pale, but are you the Palest? There's no hamsters for sale within your area. Oh my god, is there really none? For some reason, in your specific area, it did not have any pets. So we're just gonna go to Philadelphia and see what you have wherever this just sent me to. Two male chinchillas? Nope, because I said hamsters, so that's weird. Bunnies, rabbits, Chinese dwarf hamsters, Syrian hamsters. Oh, this is scary. This is very scary right here. What is this? Oh, that's a tank topper. That's a customizable tank topper right there that is baby Syrian hamsters inside of. Oh, and a rabbit. Ooh, on top of wire. Oh, no. Oh, it had babies. Oh, that's a Chinese baby hamster. Oh, no. That is not good. Oh, no. Oh, it's in your living room. Lovely. Oh, look, the hamster inside of this is climbing up the enclosure. That's a boy. Ooh, is this mixed genders? Are these mixed genders? I am scared because that one right there at least is a boy. They should be at this point in their life separated by genders. So is this just a boys group? It might be. I see another ball sack area. Oh, you see that right there? That water bottle? That just screams breeder. Oh god. Oh no. Oh, I can't tell if these are girls or guys. No, these look all like guys. Okay, they at least look like they've been separated. Oh, this person is definitely a breeder. I'm flagging right here. 3 Californian bunnies, rehoming fee, mini Rex babies just born today, will be ready March 14th. Chinese dwarf hamsters, 6 available, 15. Syrian hamsters, 12 available, 15. Yeah, no, this is definitely, you're getting flagged. Bye. Nope, I am not happy. I am not happy at all. Flag the breeders. Obviously, they're breeding multiple species of animals. Not okay. This is not a rescue. It doesn't claim that they're a rescue. It doesn't claim anything. It's just money, money, money. So let's type in gerbil, shall we? Maybe there's gerbils in this area. Oh no. These don't even look like gerbils, but they are. I can tell. Oh no. Sometimes they just put them in these types of bins so that they can take photos of them. But I have known people on Craigslist to keep them in very tall plastic bins. And they do that so that they can provide as little as nothing because they value them like feeders. Some gerbils are looking for a permanent home. Some gerbils. I bet you they're gonna keep some and keep breeding. They are a few months old. The adoption fee is 7 each. But this looks so bad. This right here. They have really poor camera quality. That's very sad. That's just very sad. Okay, we're changing it up here. Sorry, Philadelphia. You have really pathetic ads in your area. I was gonna say people, but hey, that could be also true. Who knows? The palest, let me know about how pleasant your area is, because that did not look pleasant to me. All right, Ivy. Let's just type in San Antonio. There we go. Let's see what we got. Hamster, we got 10 in for sale and 10 in community. 2 hamster cages, hamster food, and other. I'm gonna click on that. Okay, we have to click on all of them. I wanna see this. Wow, $200? Oh my good lord. Oh. And then let's just type in hamsters here, see if anything else pops up. Nope. Let's go to community now. Let's see if anything pops up. Young 2 males. Oh, these look all like breeders and or accidentals. Short-tailed opossum. What's this doing in here? Woo! $150 price tag right here. She is a beautiful Syrian hamster. Sadly, I cannot care for her anymore and want to find a great home for her. She will come with all of her stuff. Gee, can you please include all the stuff? Because, you know, you're just throwing down a price tag of $150. Clearly, there's a bin cage here, which you have already messed up. Having a hole inside of there, if someone doesn't want that bin cage to have that hole there and takes the water bottle out and places it even higher up, because guess what? You place the water bottle so stinking low, you can't even add any more bedding inside of there. Plus, it actually looks like it's a smaller, once we take a look at it, it looks like it's a small little shoebox size bin, because it looks like you can only fit from that angle all the way up to the wheel, that 7-inch flying saucer wheel. And that is a Syrian hamster pup. That looks like it's only a couple months old. Already, couple month old hamster, and you're giving this one away, and oh no, that's the carrier it came in, you can totally tell. Oh my god, this is probably pictures of the hamster that they got last week and then decided they didn't want it anymore. Yeah, no, this is terrible. I mean, you can literally see the carrier right there. And as you can tell by the size of carrier, it's the length of the hamster itself. With a little bit more room due to it being a baby. So, yeah, no, that bin is tiny. The person is trying to make money from this ad. I am flagging your shit. I'm sorry. That is a no. You were desperately trying to make more money than what this whole thing is worth. This is not good. Anyways, oh, hey, look, this is one that was posted a month ago, and we have a backstory. Her name is Peanut, and she loves to hang out with you and watch you do stuff around the room. Sadly, I cannot care for her anymore. I need a new home for her. She would be the perfect Christmas present. No, let's not be promoting that. So we have new photos of this hamster, which actually, yeah, it is the same hamster. The ears are the same. I was about to say one looks like a shorter version of the other one, but no, they're both long-haired, possibly female. But you can clearly see from one side to the other, that bin right there. Let me just zoom in. That bin right there is tiny. Look at where the carpet starts and where it's continuing on this side. It's very tiny. Just knowing that it's only from what I can assume is maybe a 10 quart, because I realize those things are really small. This is bad, and they're asking $200 for it. $200! Even though it is being supplied the correct type of bedding, and it does at least have a wheel, even though it's not the appropriate wheel, and at least it has a hide, so yeah, it's gonna be a number 2. Yikes! Not good. Hamster, $40. Hamster for sale includes cage, wheel, water feeder, exercise ball, and food. So let's take a look. Syrian hamster short-haired. The wheel is inside the enclosure here. And this is what I tell you guys when I say that usually the wheel is either not inside of the enclosure or it's in the enclosure, but it's not even set up. So this looks like it's completely not being used at all. This hamster is being provided with almost nothing. Those look like aspen shavings, and aspen shavings lately have been coming out very big, and I don't like that. And they're from Petco too, so I don't like that either. But this is like around 120 square inch enclosure. The wheel's not being properly used. They need wheels in there 24/7 due to their energy, and that energy needs to go somewhere. This is a shoebox size enclosure, and their territory, or how much they travel in the wild, is about 5 to 10 miles. So in captivity, they usually run on the wheels for up to an average of 5 miles per night. So, oh, that's so sad. Even though the wheel is too tiny for that Syrian to use, it's still not being used, and that hamster probably is so stressed. And as you can see, the bedding up top looks like it does have some either cotton or paper bedding up there, but it is packed up there. But unfortunately, when it gets so packed up there, it actually breaks the top loft area on these critter trails, where a lot of the times they just completely push themselves out. But if we take a closer look here, it looks like, and you can probably see it in the photo, this hamster enclosure is sitting on top of guinea pigs. This is disgusting. This is someone that doesn't have the room or the courtesy to make sure that these two species of animals are separate. What happens if that Syrian hamster escapes that and falls into the guinea pig enclosure? That would be a very serious fight. I would be very nervous. You could just tell by the bar spacing too. Looking up at that bar spacing of the critter trail versus the one down below, that looks like it has guinea pigs inside of it. Oh, and just like I said, the background, you can really tell a lot about a person by their backgrounds. And that looks absolutely messy. Windows covered, stuff on floor. I mean, I do have stuff on floor in my bedroom here, but it's not as bad. But at the same time, it just shows you kind of like little and lack of care, especially when there's like a rhesus right behind her. It's just like, why can't people treat small animals like, you know, fish, for instance? A lot of people, when they have fish tanks, they have stands, they prop them up somewhere. It looks nice. It's the centerpiece of the house. With rodents, animals, small animals, because sometimes people don't like me using rodents for some reason, but that's what they are. They just don't get shown the same type of courtesy as fish do, surprisingly enough. And same applies to reptiles. For some reason, these enclosures are so unappealing that they stack them on top of each other, or they leave them in such messy areas. But there is no chew toys. That is also another point. And their wheel is not being used, so it's downright neglectful and sad. Male Syrian hamster. Rehoming my male Syrian hamster, Mickey. He is healthy and loves to run on his wheel and eat carrots. Asking for $20 to ensure he goes to a good home. $60 and he will come with a 40-gallon breeder tank, 2 hamster houses, bowl, wheel, water bottle, sand bath, and sand. Hamster bedding and food not included. In my area, usually for a good rehoming fee with some sort of setup is usually about $25 to $30. So just people rehoming the hamster for about $20, which is how much you would pay for usually around there in the pet store, which I would say Syrian hamsters, depending on if it's long-haired, if it's a short-haired, or if what they consider teddy bear fancy, which would be kind of what he is considered, then usually that's about $25.99. So it's not too far off from what they originally paid for. But at least they're giving people the option. And $60, he will come with a 40-gallon tank. I'm not so sure if that is on top of the $20 or saying that for $60, you can get him and the tank. But it sounds like here, for the whole setup, it's about $80, which is not too bad considering that 40-gallon breeder tanks cost about $100. But during the dollar per gallon sale, 40-gallon breeder tanks are usually cut in half for the price tag at Petco. But we can see here, the items purchased is from PetSmart, because that is a PetSmart hide in the background. That's a PetSmart water bottle and water bottle guard. So technically, just from what I can see from just the side view of this, that these items might actually exceed how much they're asking for, which this would be an okay rehoming fee. It's not the greatest rehoming fee that I've seen, but it is acceptable for what they are offering here. So I say this person is legit trying to rehome their animal. And even though I can't really judge the enclosure due to how small and terrible of a view this is, at least they're trying, and I applaud them. And just hearing they have a 40-gallon breeder tank for a Syrian hamster, That's at least doing good. I can only give it that because I can't really judge it, but at least it's doing good. So thank you guys so much for watching today's video. I have to cut it here just because it's going on for a long time and we're not really reviewing Craigslist ads like we usually do. We're actually just kind of taking a look at you guys and your areas. So it was quite interesting to film this video today and I will be doing more of these in the future. So if you would like to, leave some requests down below for your area and maybe I'll check them out in the future. So thank you guys so much for watching. Hit like to show support, comment down below with anything you'd like to say, and subscribe if you're new here and would like to become a part of the Munchkin family. So thank you guys so much for today, and I'll see you around in the next video. Bye-bye!